Join me for part one of giving ASI Graphics a design idea. We're going to convert this in fast forward on Photo P. We're going to have lots of fun with shapes on Canva. Let's jump in and do this. Our process starts by opening up a blank logo canvas. And if you're one of those people that really struggle with color and you haven't done color theory, Canva has beautiful styles that you could go under design and pick colors that were creatively picked by Canva's very professional and creative people who know colors very well. So you can play around with the color palettes that have been put together and pick a color that you want and then start designing. With our first logo, we're going to be using shapes to create the art that's going to go with our logo. So we're going to add a circle and then change the color of the circle and make it white. And then go back to our elements and add a line and enlarge your line to add a cross in the line. So you can always use your lines and grids so that you have a perfect straight line. And once that's done, you're going to go back to your elements and you're going to search for a curved line. And then you're going to add a curves so that you create the internet world or how the internet looks like using your shapes on Canva. Okay, awesome. So we are going to go to our lines and shapes and we're going to look for an arch down. We're going to add your arch down and we're going to look for a nice color. Once you have your arch up, you're going to duplicate the arch up, rotate it, and then align it so that it shows back to back. We're just going to reduce that and then align it without any extra space on there. I'm going to group the two shapes so that they are one. And then I'm going to go to our elements and I'm going to search for a curved line. So I'm going to use this very hand-drawn curved line and I'm going to add it on there and line it up on our mouse. Because what we're creating here is a mouse. So you're going to line it up so that it looks like that. And then curve it quite nicely and make the color of your line to be the same as the background, because we're going to be using our remove tool. We're going to make it white so that the lines become extra spaces. So you're going to just align it on top of your curve until it is completely on both sides. So you can always zoom in to manage this sizing of your elements so that it is completely spot on. Next, you're going to press L for line and you're going to rotate the line. Also make this one as white and then align it on your mouse so that it is creating a nice little gap. So we want to make this one a little bit thicker, like a size 8. And then remove it so that it is center. Next, you're going to go back to your elements and you're going to go to your shapes and your lines, and you're going to scroll down and you're going to look for the pill shape. You're going to add your pill, you're going to reduce the size of your pill and then rotate it so that it is pointing up. Change the color and make that white and then align it on your mouse. And that completes the creation of your mouse. Move your mouse to the side and there's your world. Also, your two shapes that we wanted to create for this design are nicely done. So the last thing you're going to add on here is the name of your business. So we're gonna enlarge our tool, press T for text and start typing. So it's ASI Graphics. So we want the AS to be nice and big and huge, and we want that gorgeous color that we used over there. I'm happy with our beautiful orange, and we're going to use a font that's called Alta for our design, and we're going to make the size of our font 230, and the font name is Alta. And then we want to duplicate the text, and the last is going to be our eye. We want the eye to be standing on its own because we don't want it to be aligned for design purposes. We want it to be a little bit lower, and we're going to add our chord for our line for the design. So we're going to grab our earth. We're going to change the color and make that all of it orange, and then move it so that we have an eye that's aligned to our S. And then we're going to go back to our elements, and we're going to look for a curved line. And with our curved line, we want a nice curvy line. I'll give you the name of this line that we've used. It is called Hand-Drawn Curved Line by Creative Clip Clouds Images. You're going to just add it once to the design, and then you're going to flip it horizontally and bring it to the bottom of the words, and then move it so that it's curving and it's also orange. And we want the curve to be a little bit thicker, so we're going to duplicate it, align it, and add it to the first curve line. Add another one. We want it to be just a little bit thicker. Can always group these and duplicate them. And then we're gonna grab our mouse, and we're gonna move that to the design. Rotate that. We're gonna zoom a little bit out, highlight everything, align it to the design. And this is our first ASI graphics. The last step would be for you to download the design as a transparent background, jump in on Photopea, and convert it to 3D. If you enjoy these tutorials, please visit our playlist. I have videos that are converting to 3D in slow mode, so don't kill me. Have an awesome day. I'll see you on the next video.